The stage, Authentize.
Oh. Hi, I'm Andre. This is Robert. Before I came to the Valley in 2012, I ran a VC fund in Nigeria. At the time, my wife was a general counsel for an oil company, and her company lost $30 million in a four-month period because a part broke on the oil rig, and the company that made it went out of business 20 years ago. So when I came to Singularity University, we realized that 3D printing is going to shift the supply chain problem by making pieces closer to the point of use. But when we dug into this, we realized that there was one big snag. The snag is this: designers don't want to share their content. It's like the music industry. They worry about it getting lost. 80% of top designers told us they don't want to share their content without some kind of protection. And that's where Authentize comes in. We take the file and we stream it directly into the printer so that the content owner doesn't have to share the raw design file with the customer. So Robert will show you how this works in the example of cgtrader.com, one of our launch clients who just got funded by Intel Capital. So after the user goes through the normal checkout process that you can see here, the object is transferred to us via an API, and a widget URL is sent back to the user. With that widget URL, he starts the print process, and we start transforming the file into 3D printable data and streaming it layer by layer directly into the printer. So we're really handling a massive problem for the industry, because without content, there are no use cases. Without use cases, there are no printer sales. Next year, we just signed up our first Fortune 100 client, and next year, they're going to be releasing 2 million designs into the marketplace. Real, usable, spare parts, door handles, and stuff like that. The reality is that, at the moment, you can't download more than 300,000 in the market right now, even on Thingiverse.com, the largest website. So really, what we're thinking is that the massive release of high-quality data is going to completely disrupt the way supply chains work. And in all honesty, even without that anecdote I told you at the beginning, it's really not before time. We realized when we were researching this that just to move stuff from A to B, we spent 8.5% of GDP. And to store it at B, we spend about the same again. And then we dug into 3D printing and we realized that it could do something about it. It's making real spare parts like this gear knuckle for an aircraft. Right? GE just released the jet fuel nozzle, which is an incredible feat of engineering. And it's installed in all major new jet planes. Boeing has 400 pieces across its range of planes. Your hearing aids, your hip implants, your dental crowns, all 3D printed. So obviously, we want to make sure that those parts are printed correctly, especially once they're being made out of your control. And what we realized is that in addition to authenticating, so providing the intellectual property, there's a whole bunch of other tools that are required to make it happen. Tools like tools such as remote quality assurance or ERP integration. All of those applications are lying on top of our data stream, so we're making those possible. And the reality that they're starting to exist now proves one thing to me. Distributed manufacturing is here to stay. It's coming faster than we might imagine. Manufacturers are already being transformed into intellectual property publishers. So if they want help with that transformation, they can give us a call. We'll sort them out with protection, and we'll make sure that their objects are 3D printed and they're ready for the 3D printing era. Thank you.